Hello everyone, welcome back to the presentations on the classification of phylum Echinodermata. In this presentation we will be looking into the features and example under class Holothuroidea. The class Holothuroidea, the name comes from the Greek term Holothurion, which means sea cucumber. So it is in the form of sea cucumbers, okay, and approximately it includes almost like 1500 species and whose members are commonly referred as sea cucumbers, okay. So it's a group of leathery and almost cylindrical echinoderms, and we can see that sea cucumbers, they are found in all depths in all oceans, where they crawl over hard substrates or burrow through softer substrates, okay. Sea cucumbers, they have no arms. This is a typical sea cucumber. You can see they don't have any, like, no arms. They have the body is long, cylindrical, and almost bilaterally symmetrical. The body wall, it is leathery and dermomuscular in nature. Okay, they have a very elongate. They are elongate along oral aboral axis, so mouth and anus, it is on the opposite side, and so the oral aboral axis, it is very elongated. These lie on they lie on one side, which is usually flattened. The other side, which is towards the substratum, it is actually almost flattened, and as a permanent ventral side it is, and so it gives them a secondary bilateral symmetry. Okay, the tube feet, it's surrounding the mouth. So here you can see here the tube feet surrounding the mouth. They are enlarged, highly modified, and they are referred as tentacles. Okay, so mouth is encircled by a crown of retractile tube feet. It is known as the buccal podia, which are modified as oral tentacles. Okay, most adults range in length between 10 to 30 centimeters, and their body wall, as already mentioned, it is like leathery, it is thick, it is muscular in nature, and it lacks protruding spines. Okay. Or even the pedicellariae, the radial arms, spines, and pedicellariae, they are absent. Okay, radial arms in the sense the arms. Okay, you can't see any arms in the case of sea cucumbers. Okay, then beneath the epidermis, it is the dermis, which is a thick layer of connective tissue with embedded ossicles. Okay, dermal ossicles, they are microscopic, vestigial, and loosely scattered. Then the sea cucumber ossicles, they do not function in determining body shape. Larger ossicles, they form a calcareous ring that encircles the oral end of the digestive tract, which serves as a point of attachment for body wall muscles. Okay. Beneath the dermis, so first we have the epidermis, then we have the dermis, and then beneath the dermis is a layer of circular muscles which overlie longitudinal muscles. Okay, the body wall of the sea cucumbers, it is known as tripang in Asian countries. When it is boiled and dried, it is referred as tripang, and it may be eaten as a main course item or added to soups as flavoring and a source of protein. So it is again edible as well. Okay, now madriporite, it is present, but it is not external. Okay, the madriporite of sea cucumbers, it is internal, and the water vascular system, it is filled with coelomic fluid. Okay, so in most of the cases, the madriporite poric canals have no external openings or hydropores, and it is completely internal. Umbilical grooves are absent. Okay, the ring canal of the water vascular system, it encircles the oral end. Here you can see the ring canal over here. Okay, so these are the tentacles, the oral tentacles, right? So here you can see the internal portions, the anus and the mouth on the opposite sides, and the oral aboral axis is very elongated. And this is the ring canal we were mentioning, which actually encircles the oral end of the digestive tract and give rise to the pollen vesicles, almost like 1 to 10 pollen vesicles you can see over here. Okay, five radial canals and the canals of the tentacles branch from the ring canal. Okay, you can see here, these are the structures we were referring to. Okay, this is the ring canal. Okay, and these are the sac-like structures, these are the pollen vesicles. Okay, Now, the radial canals and the what do you call tube feet with suction cups and ampullae, they run between the oral and the aboral poles. Okay, you can see here the tube feet, right? So the tube feet, you can see it it is arranged along the radial canals. Here you can see. Okay, which runs from the oral to the aboral region. Okay. The side of the sea cucumber, when it is resting on the substrate, it contains three of the five rows of tube feet over here. Here you can see. Okay, so when it is resting, you can see on the aboral surface, on the surface which is visible, the side of the sea cucumber resting on the substrate, it contains three of the five rows of the tube feet, which are primarily used for attachment and locomotion. So here you can see the locomotory tube feet. Okay, five rows are there, five rows of tube feet along the radial canal, and these tube feet, the part of the body which is closer to the substratum, almost we can see the ventral surface, that part contains three rows of the tube feet out of the five. Okay, and the two rows of the tube feet on the upper surface, it is reduced in size or even maybe absent. Okay, so they form the what you call the sensory tube feet. So tube feet, you can see over here, there are of three kinds. One around the mouth, it is the buccal tube feet, the tentacles, etc. It gets modified to form the oral tentacles. Then we have the three rows of tube feet which are arranged along the radial canal extending from the mouth to the anus, and those three rows of tube feet, it is used for attachment and locomotion, and they are considered to be the locomotory tube feet. Okay, then the other two rows of the tube feet found on the surface away from the substratum, it is highly reduced and they don't take part in locomotion, and these are considered to be the sensory tube feet. Okay, so this is a typical example under the holothuria. It is holothuria. You can see over here, this is structure. Okay, coming back to the features of holothuria. So we have already seen that the ambulacral grooves, it is long coiled and it is with definite cloaca, and they have very important feature, it is the presence of respiratory trees or cloacal gills. Okay, as already mentioned, the we can see that most of the sea cucumbers, they feed upon particulate organic matter using their oral tentacles. Okay, these structures, and the mucus covering the tentacles, they trap the foot as the tentacles sweep across the substrate or are held out in seawater. Okay, the digestive tract, which consists of, over here you can see the stomach, you can see here the intestinal part. Okay, and then it ends in a cloaca and the opens out through anal opening. So they do have a very specific cloaca. Okay, the sea cucumbers, they thrust tentacles into their mouths to wipe off trapped food, and during digestion, the coelomocytes, they move across the intestinal wall, they secrete enzymes to aid in digestion, and they engulf and distribute the products of digestion. So the coelomocytes helps in the transport of nutrients, absorption of nutrients, digestion of nutrients, etc. Okay, now the coelom is very it is very large. It is, and the cilia of the coelomic canal actually helps in circulating the fluid throughout the body cavity. Okay, it helps in distributing respiratory gases, waste, nutrients, etc. Right, now as already mentioned, that respiratory tree, okay, a pair of tubes called respiratory tree, it attaches, you can see over here, a tree like highly branched structure. So this is what is referred as a respiratory tree, and this respiratory tree attached to the rectum, and they branch throughout the body cavity of the sea cucumber. Okay, it may extend throughout the body cavity of the sea cucumber. The pumping action of the rectum, it circulates water into these respiratory tubes, and when the rectum dilates, water moves through the anus into the rectum. Contraction of the rectum along with contraction of the anal sphincter it forces water into the respiratory tree. Okay, so when the rectum it the pumping action of the rectum, actually it helps in entering of water entry into these into this tube, okay, into the rectal tube. Okay, so then what happens, the whole part is filled with water. Now the anal sphincter, it contracts, okay, it reduces in size, fine, almost it closes. Similarly, there is muscular contraction of the rectal wall. Okay, as a result, the water has to be pushed to some other parts. Okay, so at that time, what happens is the water is pushed into these tubes of the respiratory tree. Okay, so the contraction of the rectum along with the contraction of the anal sphincter, it forces water into the respiratory tree. Okay, so water exits the respiratory tree when tubules of the tree contracts. Okay, the tubules of the tree, when it contracts, the water from the tubule, it moves out, it is expelled out. Now, respiratory gases and nitrogenous waste, they move in between the coelom filling the body cavity and the seawater inside the tubules. Okay, so across the tubules and between the coelom and the the water inside the respiratory tree, the gaseous exchange take place. Okay, so it helps in actually respiration as well as the removal of waste substances from the organism. Okay, so this is about the respiratory tree, or it is known as the cloacal gill. Okay, that is very unique in the case of holothuria, right? And the circulatory system, it is more advanced than any of the other echinoderms, and it functions, as already mentioned, to transport oxygen and also nutrients and waste. Development, most of the sea cucumbers, they are dioecious in nature, and they possess a single gonad located anteriorly in the coelom. Okay, so here you can see the gonad over here, right? And it is located anterior in the coelom, yeah, and single gonopore near the base of the tentacles. Okay, here you will be able to find the gonopore, okay, the opening of the gonoduct or the gonopore, right? And the fertilization, it is usually external, and the embryos, they develop into planktonic larvae, okay, free swimming planktonic larvae. That is, the development is indirect, and with a larval form, it is known as the auricularia. Okay, so holothuria, they are commonly referred as sea cucumbers, and they are sluggish creatures, and move partly by means of their ventral tube feet and partly by waves of contraction in their muscular body wall. Most sedentary species, they trap the suspended food particles in the mucus of the outstretched oral tentacles, or they pick up particles from the surrounding surface. As already mentioned, they sweep their the oral tentacles in the on the substratum, and then they collect the food from the surrounding surface. Okay, and what they do then? They then stuff their tentacles into the pharynx one by one, ingesting the captured food. Okay, there are still others which crawl along the substrate, grazing the bottom with their tentacles. So nature of the sea cucumbers in general. We also saw the example the holothuria. Okay, it is a very common sea cucumber. Okay, so this is about the class holothuria and the example holothuria. Thank you.